switch off.
Stop. You're on the serial number. Set the dials on zero. Wait here. Is this your car?
Belongs to a friend. It broke down.
What's wrong with it?
That's what I'd like to know. Is there a garage around here? I walked up the road a mile or two. Everything's closed.
At this time of night, no wonder. Do you have your papers, please?
Hope so.
Salesman. Business trip or pleasure?
Business.
You make a living with that?
It depends. On how often the car breaks down. Could you give me a ride back to town?
I'd like to, but you know, some of our regulations are strange. I can't take you in my car unless you're under arrest.
Ah, okay then. I'll sleep in the car till daylight.
Good luck. Enjoy your visit.
Thank you. Leave those. They must be recorded. What's going on?
I don't get it.
What was the name of your boat?
Arax. She should have docked last night.
Well, find out. That's your job, damn it.
Say, you should call the
docks.
Yeah, I came in harbor.
I wasn't supposed to dock right here. The Arryx was supposed to dock at 2 a.m. She was seen entering the harbor. That's all I know.
If she came into port, she must be here someplace.
I contacted the captain a month ago. It was all set.
You made it clear to him that it was an organized tour?
$2,000 a head for third-class passage. He damn well knew it wasn't for a pleasure cruise.
Well, okay then. If it's not a ghost ship, we'll track her down.
Take another boat?
We could, but we'd need a captain who won't ask questions.
Storm damage. Nothing serious. She'll be ready to sail in 5 days.
Damn.
It's not my fault.
I'm not blaming you. You're sure the captain won't change his mind when he reads the papers?
We can add, but he can read. In 5 days, we sail. No problem.
Drive down to the end of the dock and wait for us. We're going through that silo. We'll meet you there.
You're crazy. There's no reason to go through there.
Well, I hope there's no reason. But right now, you don't discuss, you do it.
Wait here.
Run.
You and Renzi go back to your hideout.
You'll be okay. No one's seen you. You think the caretaker at the villa recognized you?
I'm afraid so. I went there 3 times to take measurements for the carpeting.
Well, we got to get you out of town.
I'll phone and tell you where I am.
Okay.
Great. First-class hotels, huh?
I stayed here 2 months getting ready. You can stand it for 4 days.
Are you going to say goodbye to me nicely?
The day I'll say goodbye nicely, you'll be leaving for China. Don't forget to call me every day at noon at the Hilton Bar. Now go on.
Thank you.
You know there's a speed limit in this town.
Sorry, I'm a foreigner. I can't read signs in your language.
Numbers are the same in every language. We're very lenient with foreigners. As long as they don't go too far. Do you know how fast you are going?
20? 30? 40? 50? Oh, don't tell me I was doing 60, right in the middle of town.
You were doing 90.
Oh, my foot must have got wedged on the accelerator. Usually I'm a very safe driver.
You're lucky you ran into me. Any other officer would have confiscated your license. Goodbye, Mr.
Azad. It happens to mean free in certain language.
My name is Abel Zachariah. It means nothing at all. Inspector Zachariah.
Good morning, Inspector. My name is Malik. I represent the insurance company. Mr. Tasco is waiting for you. He just came back from St. Moritz in his private plane.
Oh, Lydia. How nice of you. No, no, darling. I'm not in St. Moritz anymore. I'm calling you from home. I just got back this morning. I've been robbed, darling. My emeralds, the whole lot. I'll pass you to Isabel. The police are here. Isabel? Oh, darling, you read too many detective stories. In real life, they're not all that brilliant. They fill up their files with papers and then forget the whole case.
Hello? Yes. I'm very upset about it. Oh, yes. I think the police did send somebody. You are mad. Of course we won't change our plans. In 2 weeks, we'll be sailing for the tropics. The crew is all ready.
Well, I suppose it's no use asking if you've found a lead.
Mr. Tasco, I understand your impatience. They're your emeralds. But never ask a policeman if he's found a lead.
Oh, really? Why not?
Superstition. To catch a thief who's wandering around in the middle of a million people, you must have faith. You must believe in the supernatural.
My husband called the Minister of Justice.
I do believe. A policeman's great strength is that he's paid by the year. He never files a case. May I?
If you wish. They took nothing but the emeralds, and the collection is valued at $1 million. He must be a specialist.
Well, it still is a rat. Yes, that's fine.
It's all yours, Inspector.
Bye-bye now.
If you find my emeralds, of course.
And my company is also prepared to pay a reward of 10%.
See you Monday.
Well, gentlemen, perhaps we'll be able to modernize our offices. They could certainly use it.
If I were you, I'd also buy a new car. We heard you coming a mile away. And burglars have pretty sharp ears.
Mm-hmm. You can take it at the bar, sir.
Hello. Yes? I'm Mr. Azad. I'll take it here. Hello, Elan. Yes, all quiet here. How about you? You like the place? Found a good hotel?
Oh, the place is full of them. It's a local Riviera.
Great.
You needed a vacation.
I wanted to ask you something. Can I go out?
What do you mean, can you go out? Of course you can.
I mean, with somebody.
Why not? Just don't talk too much.
You don't mind?
Why should I? If somebody asks you, go ahead.
Well, I just wanted to know.
Know what?
If I could go out with a man.
What is this, a riddle? It's the first time you ever asked me a question like that.
Because it's the first time I'll be going out without you.
Well, listen, hang up. If you waste all your money on phone calls, you won't be able to go out. Call me tomorrow, same time. Too bad.
Like that. Now you can pin it up over your bed.
I'd never get to sleep. Just seeing you, I am all wound up. May I?
Of course.
Now that we are such intimate friends. Does it pay well?
Depends on the photographer.
If I was a photographer.
But you're not. The way you look at me, your pictures would be out of focus.
Oh, I can dream, can't I?
No, you can't. I'm only for sale at the newsstand.
Doesn't it bother you to pose bare, like that?
No. You know, 2 years ago, I only showed my legs, and that was shocking. Now I show more, and it shocks less. It's really weird, isn't it?
People used to read these in hot little rooms, alone with their hot little imaginations. Now the cry is for sex in public. That's what shocks me.
Oh, now, come on, listen. As pleasures go, you know, drinking leads to the DTs, and drugs lead to the psycho ward, but sex, I mean, sex merely leads to an act of love. Would you like to pose? We're looking for a man.
I have one principle. Never try to replace a profession.
Right, but who says you can't get educated?
Who is the teacher?
Follow the leader.
The most erotic nightclub in the world, the El Dorado. It's heaven. It's hell. The show that will shock you, grab you, thrill you.
Hi. You wait right here. I'll be back in a couple seconds.
The El Dorado Erotic Theater presents the most daring spectacle ever staged. And here, direct from Hamburg, are Sigrid and Marlene in their super erotic number, The House of Love.
Shadow town, haunting of love. Hello, Siegfried. A glass of water, please.
Good evening, gentlemen. As you can see, I've been waiting for you. I don't like to drink alone. I see there are only two of you left.
What do you want?
The emeralds.
We don't know anything.
Oh. Sit down, please. I was going to offer you a drink, but you're not reasonable. It's been years since I took a drink. First glass. Now we'll see if alcohol affects my aim. pretty bad. Generally, I never miss a bullseye. Somehow I think that alcohol and firearms don't go together. Second glass.
Listen, you can search the place. You won't find anything. And besides, you're trespassing.
That was for your first stupid remark. And this is for the second.
Bastard!
The alcohol is beginning to take effect. I almost killed you. If I were sensible, I wouldn't drink anymore. Where are the emeralds?
Listen, Inspector. It wasn't us who hid...
The what?
The emeralds.
Aha! A confession. Take a note, Sergeant. They confess to everything. Relax. I came all alone. The last clip. Better hurry. My aim is getting considerably less accurate. Where are the emeralds? See, accidents do happen. I have only one round left. But I can't miss you from this close. Where is Azad? Hello, Mr. Azad. Remember me? What a town. You can't take two steps without running into someone you know. Steak and French fries. It's the best way to attract attention. The same as usual, for two.
For Mr. Zakaria, for two.
Oh, really? Don't worry. Tonight you're my guest. Confidentially, I never pay here. Tell me, what are local specialties? Me, for instance. I chase petty crooks like you. I take all those risks for $300 a month. Don't you find that outrageous?
You have fringe benefits. You race around in your car. You sit at whatever table you want. You don't pay in restaurants. It all adds up.
One good turn deserves another. Where are the emeralds?
Just for, what do you call it?
Dolma. It's rice wrapped in vine leaves, soaked in oil. Eat it, it loosens the tongue.
Mmm. The last 24 hours, we've been like Siamese twins.
Oh, that's what I ate for 20 years. It's my whole youth. It couldn't go on. Rubbing elbows with people like you, a man acquires expensive tastes. Now I've decided to work for myself for a change.
Since when?
Since last night in front of the villa. When I took the car keys, I guessed everything. That's why I didn't try the ignition.
Bad business for a cop. We've each got a job to do. You want to do both. That makes complications.
Not at all. It's very simple. I play both sides. If things go wrong, I start acting like a policeman again. So why don't you tell me? Where are the emeralds?
You are really decadent.
Decadent, yes. But easygoing. I'm giving you time to digest. Think it over. You have until 5 o'clock tomorrow afternoon to hand over those emeralds to me personally. Otherwise, I throw you in jail.
We split?
I want the whole collection. I don't do things by halves.
What if I accept?
Home free. You and your friends leave town with no worries. Come on, Mr. Azad. I offer you the possibility to go on living on steak and French fries and you quibble.
Mm-mm. That's good. What is it?
This is called Imam Bayaldi. The legend is a sultan fainted when he tasted it, so they named the dish after him. It's better this way.
Not bad. And what are you eating?
It's called moussaka. One layer of sliced fried eggplant, one layer of ground meat seasoned with local herbs like mint, marjoram, a little bit of cinnamon, another layer of eggplant, a layer of fresh tomatoes, one layer of white sauce, some grated cheese, and the whole thing baked in the oven.
And what is this delicacy you don't want to share with me?
This is codfish roe.
I see they like to mix things up around here.
That depends. Here, look. This, for example, is kasher. It's a fine cheese browned in butter. Would you like to try some?
No, thanks.
You're not hungry anymore? I hope I didn't spoil your appetite.
You did. I was peacefully eating a piece of grilled steak and...
That's what I object to. You wanted to eat all by yourself. Very well. I shall respect your privacy. See you tomorrow before 5 o'clock. Here. It's easier to reflect over a good cigar. And... Mr. Azad, you are staying in town, are you not? Your face is very familiar to our border police. It's on me.
Well,
I told you not to come near me. What happened?
He just shot Renzi.
Damn. You want to see a doctor?
Forget it. It's nothing. I'll take care of it tomorrow.
You have Tasco's telephone number?
Yeah, why?
Give it to me.
Here.
Let's go. Hello? I'd like to speak to Mr. Tasco, please. This is Santa Claus. No, it's not a gag. Tell him it's about the emeralds. Hello, Mr. Tasco. Be at Inspector Zakaria's office at 5 tomorrow afternoon, if you want your emeralds back.
I'm going to see a friend. Pick me up in half an hour. I came unarmed.
That was your mistake. Sit down. What do you get in this country for killing a dirty bastard?
You get hanged. I get a medal posthumously. They always catch a cop killer.
That's the risk I take.
Your friend's death. It was an accident.
What have you got there? A bad tooth? Don't move your jaw. This might go off by itself. I fire, and you have no more teeth, no more jaw. But you'll be alive. Alive with no jaw. No more vine leaves. No more dolmas soaked in oil. Maybe here. Or here. It goes in here and comes out in back. Two nice clean holes, as big as emeralds. But what a mess in between. No brain. Just daylight showing through.
Listen. I came here to talk business. You're not going to hand over those emeralds for peanuts. I accept your proposition. 50-50 and you leave the country.
I've got it. I'll shoot here. You'll be one-eyed and paralyzed. Your vision will be 50-50. One, two, three!
So, now we're on even terms. Maybe I won't get the emeralds, but I will get something. In the name of the law, I place you under arrest.
Up yours.
Look, if we don't come to a friendly agreement, Mr. Tasco will get his emeralds back. He'd just be slightly richer.
He won't forget you.
10%.
And the other 90% in glory.
Glory? With people like you around, accidents can happen. And if I'm lucky enough to stay alive, what happens? A, I catch you, and it's all in the day's work. B, you get away, and I look like a fool.
I'm sorry to say, you're still in category B.
I forgot to tell you, I didn't come alone. Sorry, but the game will be short because there's only one racket and I'm holding it.
Yeah, but I've got the bullets.
Know something? I think it's better this way. Someone might have gotten hurt.
Disarmed, you know. He can be charming.
If I get knocked off, you pick up the emeralds. You know the mail desk in the Hilton lobby?
Yeah, I know it.
You'll find a map showing where they are in an envelope addressed to you. Remember, only in case of emergency.
I'll remember, but nothing is going to happen to you. See you Thursday.
Oh, that's for me. I'll take it here. Excuse me, I'll be right back. Hello. Azad speaking. Hello, Hélène. Yes, it's me.
How are you? Getting bored without me?
Everything's fine. We leave the day after tomorrow. Give me the name of your hotel. I'll come and get you.
Met any interesting people?
If you think I've got time for social life.
I heard something about a blonde.
Who from?
A blonde with a big book, big hat, and bad taste. I warn you, she can't read. She's only pretending to, because it looks intellectual.
What is this? Hello? Hello? What the hell are you doing here?
So I leave you just 2 days and you turn into a sex maniac. Congratulations. What is she? A pro?
Well, I thought so in the beginning, but...
Oh, I see. You're past the beginning. Fast work.
Helen, you're a pain. I told you to stay out with the peasants.
You won't be in pain much longer. Out with the peasants. I made a boy who's everything you're not. Very handsome, very polite, very affectionate.
If you keep this up, people are going to stare.
Why?
Because I'm going to clout you.
Because someone dared to take me out. Don't tell me you're jealous. Oh, dear, I have to choose. On the one hand, affection and security. On the other, adventure. Anyway, I told him I wasn't free. That was right, wasn't it, to tell him I wasn't free?
And you came here just to give me this routine.
Wasn't I right to tell him I wasn't free?
No, you were wrong.
All right. I've still got time.
May I see your identification, please?
Faster. finally is Hadrian's Arch. It was built in the 2nd century AD of marble in the form of an arch supported by two.
Mr. Azad? I know you're here. I'm going to count till 10. If you don't surrender, we shoot at everything that moves. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Yes, it's me. No, not yet.
All right. I'll call you. Bye.
Make mine a double.
Been here long?
I just got here. This is the life. Good whiskey. Cozy room. Nice pictures. But too much light. Can I try?
Yeah. One clap for off, two claps for on.
That the only game you got?
No, I have another game. Very sexy game.
I'll buy that.
Close your eyes. Now, stop me whenever you like.
Wow.
The rules say you cannot argue against the decision of fate.
Since I'm in the hands of fate.
I'll be back in a second. I just know you're one hell of a man.
And I just know you're one hell of a bitch. Which do you prefer, the cop or the robber?
You haven't given me a chance to compare them yet.
Is that why you dragged me to your show?
I did it for Zachariah. He looks the other way where the show is concerned.
He picked you to keep an eye on me.
Yes, but he didn't say why.
The first time I saw you, I should have known. I've been had like a tourist. All I need is a camera around my neck. Ah, what a mess. When the customs people see these faces, it'll ruin my reputation. They'll think I came straight out of a nut house. What about all those cops at the Hilton today?
That was me, too.
Nice going. You're proud of yourself?
No.
Okay, get dressed. You're coming with me.
You don't trust me?
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Too bad. Just when I was beginning to like the robbers better than the cops.
One more reason why you're coming with me. Let's go. Well, I must say, it's bigger than I thought.
Oh, well, there are only 54 hotels, 75 boarding houses, and 150 rooms to rent. You're not going to have the slightest trouble finding her.
I don't even know what name she's using.
Oh, well, listen, we can always settle down and wait for the warm weather. Beaches will be jammed with people, and we'll find your yo-yo working on her tan.
Oh, to hell with her. If she's going to be this stubborn, she can look after herself.
Tell me, what is this girl to you anyway?
Nothing. She counts on me, that's all.
With the triple leap of death, suspense, with the king of magic, Professor Marcy. Get your tickets now and bring the whole family to enjoy the show at the Cornelius Circus.
Tonight only at the Cornelius Circus. A big show in a little tent. Wild lions from Africa. The wise monkeys. Helene, the last boat leaves at noon. Helene, I'll be waiting for you on the dock. Spine-tingling chills with the triple leap of death. Suspense with the king of magic, Professor Marcy. At noon on the dock. The last boat leaves at noon. Do you hear me, Helene?
Unique représentation ce soir du cirque Cornelius. Un grand spectacle sous un petit chapiteau. Les lions sauvages d'Afrique. At noon on the docks. Do you hear me, Helene? N'attendez pas pour louer vos places. Venez voir ce spectacle unique en famille au cirque Cornelius ce soir. Venite a vedere questo spettacolo unico al circo Cornelius questa sera. The last boat leaves the island at noon. Helene, I'll wait for you on the dock. Unica rappresentazione del circo Cornelius questa sera. Helene, the last boat leaves the island at noon. I'll wait for you on the docks. Tonight only, at the Cornelius Circus. A big show in a little tent. Bring the whole family to enjoy the show tonight at the Cornelius Circus.
Oh, well, you better change your spiel. You're making a big fool out of yourself.
Yeah, what do you want me to say to her?
Just tell her you love her and stop giving me this crap about a debt of honor.
You don't know her. She'd think it was true.
It is true.
It is?
Mm-hmm. Is that him?
Yes.
You want to go back to him?
No, I'm staying.
Get your stuff and let's go.
Helene is not coming, so leave her alone and beat it. Got it?
How do you say young punk in this country?
What?
Let's go. Let's go!
Thank you.
and go back to your cup. But tell him not to count on me to make him a millionaire.
What am I going to do with a cop who's not even a millionaire?
That's your problem.
Are you mad at me? I know it's my fault. Listen, Azad, let me explain. I grew up. You never noticed, but I grew up. You went on being very nice to me, like when I was a kid. But what I wanted was... Oh, but what do you expect? I couldn't force you to marry me, could I?
You should have. It would have kept you out of trouble.
You know, you never looked so handsome.
And that's what you call growing up. Come on, let's go.
Zachariah's here. There was no way to warn you. It's my fault.
You got nabbed at the Hilton?
Yeah, like a sucker. I wanted to know where the emeralds were.
Now you know.
I didn't even have time to pick up your map.
Forget it. So, what's he want?
The emeralds.
One-track mind. Say, that's a compliment. General mobilization.
You let us get on the boat. We're free to go.
Now what's to guarantee if we give him the emeralds, the cops won't grab us?
I'll go ask him.
Says you're right. None of the cops but him knows us. So either he sits tight and we get on the boat, or he nods and we sleep in jail tonight.
And so?
So he thinks it's funny. Listen, Azad, he's a sadist. He'll do anything. He wants to pin Renzi's death on me. I'll give up my share.
Me too.
Go tell him it's a deal.
It's a deal.
You can go aboard, miss.
No, thank you. I'll wait for him.
Go aboard. I'll be back right away.
We share? No, Mr. Azad, we don't share. Aren't you coming down? You're not getting dizzy, I hope. If I shoot, no more brain. Just holes, Mr. Azad. Nothing but holes. And mine is real. And it's loaded. Fifty-fifty? Oh, no. The whole lot.
Thank you.